God bless you, dear students. This is your English lesson, unit number 2, War and Peace. Name of the lesson which I am going to share with you, that is the Paper Crane of Peace. So, unit number 2, War and Peace, the Paper Crane of Peace. Non-fiction. Students, fiction and non-fiction, there are two kinds of the writings are there. Non-fiction, which is based on the reality. Or gaming, you know, origami is very ancient Japanese art of paper folding. It actually began in China but spread to Japan by the 6th century, since when it has become an important part of Japanese culture. Paper butterflies made for wedding to symbolize the bride and groom are just one example of many traditional origami figures evolved over the centuries. Origamists today experiment with new materials such as film transparency and create fantastic creations from the single sheet chiffon. A contemporary American origamist has created a model of Star Trek spaceship Enterprise which takes 72 diagrams. It second pages of instructions and a week to make. But all origamists abide by the two essential rules of origami. Neither scissor nor glue is to be used. Origami is basically an art of folding paper in various shapes. Students, in this lesson you will find a new word: dizziness, crack, slender, contamination, terrible, leukemia, monument, eliminated, inscribed. You can find the meanings from the dictionary. Aims and objectives of this lesson: to develop language skills through practice in listening, reading, writing, and speaking in a progressive way. Promotion of peace and serenity to enable them. Create a healthy atmosphere and peaceful place. Pupils would be taught the lives of significant individuals in the past who have contributed to national and international achievement. How to keep legendary name alive, making the names immortal. Pupils would be taught the lives of significant individuals in the past who contributed to national and international achievement. How to keep the legendary names alive, making a new immortal. Giving the meaning of new words from lesson with accuracy through understanding the key theme. Students, this is a crane. Cranes are elegant, long-necked birds which are found in many parts of the world, particularly in wetlands where they wait. As Japan is a country of island, cranes are very common and the features in Japanese art and legends. This is called Paper Crane of Peace. You can see the different images of the war, the Second World War, when America blasts the bomb in Hiroshima. It was a great atrocity of the Americans, when tens and thousands of people died and many people suffered in different diseases. This is Sadoka, the story which I am going to share about Sadoka. She was just 2 years old while the Second World War occurred. Her name is Sadoka Sasaki. This is a atom bomb. He is a Sadoka's father and pick of a Sadoka. And this is a destruction of World War II in 1945, when America untested weapon to force Japan to surrender. On 6 August 1945, B-29 bomber dropped the world's first atomic bomb on Hiroshima city, which had until then world's first atomic bomb experienced very little conventional bombing. Students, you can see the destruction devastating the buildings. There is a Japanese legend which says that whoever folds 1,000 origami cranes will live long life. This legend took on a new and poignant significance in 1955 with the death of 12 years old girl in Japan, Sidoka Sasaki, who was born in 1943. As already I have shared about Sidoko Sasaki, she was an athlete and she was healthy and lively child. Here there is a one word, poignant. It means arousing a sense of sadness. Towards the end of the World War II in 1945, the United States of America decided to use an entirely new untested weapon to force Japan to surrender. On 6 August 1945, a B-29 bomber dropped world's first atomic bomb on Hiroshima, a city which had until then experienced very little conventional bombing. The atomic bomb exploded at 8:15 a.m., 580 meters above the city center. As already I have told you, tens of thousands of people were killed instantly by blast. Instantly mean immediately, at the spot. And the death toll rose to between 180,000 and 200,000 over the following years, as the terrible after effects of the atomic bomb claimed the lives of hundreds of thousands of people. Still, just one of these victims was Sidoko Sasaki. As I have shown the picture, she was a healthy athlete and lively child. Until one day when she was practicing for a big race, she was overcome by dizziness and collapsed. She was found to be suffered from leukemia, cancer of the blood, a direct result of contamination by the atomic bomb when she was just 2 years old. Nowadays, many kinds of childhood leukemia are curable. But in Japan, in 1950s, it was called atom bomb disease and known to be fatal. In 1950s, there was no the treatment of the leukemia. Students, Sidoko was an extremely courageous little fighter more than anything else. He wanted to recover and run race once again. Her best friend told her about the legend which said that anyone who folded 1,000 paper cranes would be granted a wish, and Sidoko's wish would be to live a long life. She believed that every grain she folded represented a wish, and so she used every scrap of paper which could be found for her to fold her cranes. Even as her friends alongside her in the hospital died, it was a student tragedy. While she was hospitalized, her friends beside the bed were dying. She kept on folding, but her wish changed when she wished that this kind of atrocity should never happen again. Atrocity means cruelty. There should be no more bombs or wars. Her wish was for peace, so that neither children nor adults should ever suffer and die like this again. Sidoko managed to fold 644 cranes before she could fold no more. She died on 25th October 1955. Her classmates and family folded the remaining 356 cranes to bury with her. But her tremendous courage and hope had been an inspiration to all who came to know of her paper folding. Her friends were determined that she should be remembered and her wish be fulfilled. Young people from all over Japan contributed money for a project which would ensure that Sidoko would never be forgotten. In 1958, a statue of Sidoko holding a golden crane was unveiled in Hiroshima Peace Park. The wish of children who worked for the project is inscribed at the bottom of the statue. This is our cry, this is our prayer, peace in the world. Today, the origami cranes have become a symbol of wish for peace. People from all over Japan and the world fold paper cranes and send them to Sidoko's monument in Hiroshima across the road. From Sidoko's peace monument in the flame of peace, it would be extinguished only in the flame of peace. It will be extinguished only when all nuclear weapons have been eliminated from the earth. Today, it is still burning. This is a monument a piece of Sudoku Sasaki.